we live. Aloha. Since you're here, I guess we better do something to entertain you. Anybody feel like dancing?
Nah.
Feel like singing?
Nah.
Feel like playing?
Nah.
Just let them watch the videos.
All right, go watch the videos. We'll be back in about 40 minutes.
Yeah.
By the way,
come here.
In the dressing room without getting out of here.
Yeah, no.
Betty, come here.
Get the hell out of here.
Oh, Jesus, Lord help us. It's you again.
Hello.
Ask yourself a question, Dad.
No.
Fine.
I can't think of one! What would you be if you weren't a musician? I'd be a drummer.
So, Tick, you know what you're going to talk about?
Don't have a clue.
Idea?
Not one.
Me, if I wasn't a musician, I'd be a drummer.
I thought this was going to be a serious conversation. Who the hell is this interviewer? I'm out of here.
Just roll. We'll take this bit.
Oh, it has been rolling.
Then you can talk seriously.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, it has been rolling. Great. Hello, this is Shorty Long with Face the Nation. Tonight's installment of David Bryan and Richard Sambora of the famous rock group Bon Jovi.
Hello. How are you? Hello. I'm just finishing my food here somewhere in America, this filthy place.
Now, all the guys in the band call me Minority. They always make me sit in the back of the bus. They always give me like cheap cigars, never give me good cigars. So, I mean, I don't think that's right.
And we have an energy that keeps us friends with each other so that we can be on the road this long without choking somebody to death.
Yeah, it's hard after all this time to be on the road, to actually just be on the road.
Or just to be. Or not to be.
Really. You pray for the energy to be breathing, except for those 2 hours that you play for the fans, and that's what we do it for.
We do it for you at home.
So.
Because we'll be there for you. These three words, I swear to you.
So here we are sitting backstage with my good friend I've known for about 110 years, it seems, these days. This is Dave Sabo.
Don't be such a wanker, man.
It's not Sabo.
It's not Sabo. It's Sabo.
That's right. So he came up to me one day. He says, John, listen, I've got a great nickname. It's going to be a hook. It'll work for me. He says, I want to call myself Worm. I says, no, it's not Worm. Snake. Snake. He says, I like it. Snake. It'll be big. He says, I've got a name for a band. I got this great new band. We got new songs. I got this guy who wears a chain in his ear. He doesn't know how to play it, but he looks good. He goes from his nose to his ear to his ear to his nose. He's got a big hoop over here. He says he wants to call himself Raquel. I says, no, Rachel. The name of the band. The name of the band. Remember when you came up to me with the name of the band? Remember that?
Yes.
Remember when you
did
that?
Yep.
Skip Rope. Skip Rope. Remember?
He said, listen, boy, you want to make it in this business, Skid Row.
Skid Row.
I said, no, Skip Rope. Kids can relate to it. It's something that they do. They exercise.
Right.
We can put out an aerobics album
true.
In conjunction with Jane Fonda.
That's right.
We'd be hell on wheels. He says, no, Skid Row.
Skid Row. For men, rock and roll, man.
No, Skip Rope. Skip
Rope. Why does he call himself Worm? No, it's Snake, not Worm. Snake.
That John Bon Jovi, he's a funny guy.
Now, in that video was actual stunt Jovis.
Stunt Jovis.
Where the real Bon Jovis won't go.
Where real Bon Jovis
they
won't
look
go.
Just like us. Even stunt now, Jovis. We could be stunt Jovis.
We could be fooling you.
And you don't like it.
You would like it, would ya? It's magic.
Come here, Snake.
Is that Hispanic blood in you?
Yeah. Go get me a cigar, will you?
So, you have any serious questions?
So far on this New Jersey tour, how many dates have you played?
We've played 176 dates so far.
Very interesting, very interesting.
Had a very good time too, I must add.
And how many people would that equal? Not big at math, December.
No,
Let's figure this out.
Well, basically,
176 times...
It's magic!
It's magic times 20 would be somewhere in the vicinity of 3,462,000.
But you have to understand, you must add Moscow and Giant Stadium to that, and all those places that we've done where I had more than 20,000 people.
We'll take an even 5 million people.
Let me stop eating.
I have to add no. What's that, Rich? We played to 5 million people. You realize that?
5 million people. Yes, we have. This has been...
A mind is a terrible thing. Remember that.
This has been a bicentennial moment.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There's one thing that you can always believe in, and that's...
He used to beat me up.
Still does.
Still does.
Regularly.
Whenever you get his hands on me. We met in Sarajevo when I was like 10 or 11 years old. And he lived up the street from me. And he used to play basketball, this blue basketball, in his driveway. I said, man, I want to play basketball with the big boys. What do you think? So he gave me a wedgie, threw me down on the ground, gave me some grass stains on my knees, and said, okay, welcome to the gang. And that's how it was. And I've been getting wedgies and grass stains ever since.
Richie Sambora, what would you do if you weren't a musician?
If I wasn't a musician, man, I'd probably be a psychologist. A tax accountant, maybe.
A taxidermist?
No, really. Seriously.
I'd probably be like a talk show host or something.
Monty!
Monty!
Monty! It's Monty!
I got a goddamn paper clip, Monty! I got one! Damn it.
This man has been on the road way too long.